Well, welcome back to Steve Rob Reviews. Today, we're going to do some electrical testing, basic electrical testing, and the type of things that you should know about electricity, basic electricity, and some of the tools that I find are very handy. The first one for most do-it-yourselfers should be this one right here. And this will check to see if the circuit that you're looking at is actually wired right from the beginning. Just a basic 120 volt circuit. And it would be an outlet like this that you would plug something like this into. So all you do is just, this is a power cord that's already powered up. And if I just plug this in, you will see here that the two lights are lit up. And there's a guide here that tells you if it's not wired right. So the two yellow lights on show that the polarity is right and it's wired right. And that's a good starting point. The second one I'd like to show is some of these electrical testers. They're non-contact electrical testers, which means you can go to a wire and you can see if there's actually electricity flowing through the circuit, if it's hot, if it's live, if the breaker has not been turned off, and you will get a shock if you don't know what you're doing, right? So these are all different styles. I got this one here, which is a Fluke, which I really don't care for too much, but it's got some features that other ones don't. And one is it's got a light on it, which is good. And if we were to, you guys can see on this plug here, you can see the black there, which is the hot wire. And on that side, the white, which is the neutral, and you can see the green ground and beside it. Now, if I were to just go like with this, on this side, you could see that nothing happens because I'm not on the hot side of the plug. I'm on the neutral side. If I turn it around, you'll see that it lights up like a purple kind of deal. And if I were to go on the ends here, you can take a look at the end here, and the smaller one is always going to be your hot. If I go on this one here, and there's a smaller one there. I don't know if you could see that or not, but it is lit up like a purple, and it's so faint it's hard to tell. And on this one here, it doesn't light up at all. And that's why I don't really care about this one so much, is I prefer the Milwaukee. There's all kinds of different brands out there. I like this one here. The reason why I like it is it's got two identifiers. It actually lights up and makes a noise. So if you take a look here, you can also tell that when it's on, you know, it's working. And if you go like this one here on the hot side, it is actually beeping and, you know, showing the light. And if you go on the other side, it's not doing nothing on the neutral. And again, if you were to go on this side of the wire, it's showing it's hot. And if you go on the opposite side, it doesn't show anything. And that's a good, you know, identifier, because a lot of times when you're working on circuits, you may have turned off your breaker and you think that the circuit, you know, is applying to this particular outlet or whatever it is, and it may not, because, you know, when you're working on electrical circuits, the wire sometimes can work for so many different areas. You've got to verify that the power is actually off. And a lot of people, what they used to do in the past, and it still works today, is a known good. So if you had, like, say, a light bulb, you know, that you just plugged in and it didn't go on, well, you got to make sure that the bulb works, right? So you plug it into a good one first and then plug it into this one and make sure that the circuit isn't on. And this is a great identifier here because, you know, sometimes you could plug it into this outlet here, and by the time you get to the next one, what happens if the bulb goes out? Well, that kind of stuff has happened, so you got to be careful with electricity. So we're going to do some basic checks, and I'm going to explain to you some stuff that maybe a lot of people don't know for basic electricity. And one of them is going to be on the back of a outlet here, or a switch. This is a switch. And a lot of people don't like to see anything on the back there. They only like to do their wiring on the sides using the screws. And we're gonna get into that, and that's a little controversial, but I don't mind a little controversial. So let's get to it now, and I'll show you some stuff that maybe you just don't know. Well, let's get started right here. And of course, most people should have just your basic multimeter, and I've got it set here on continuity. So when you touch the two pieces together that are in continuity, it will, of course, make a noise. So if we just take a look at your regular switch here, and a lot of switches you'll see, they just have one connector here and one connector here, and it just turns your light off and on. Now for most lights, if you take a really good look there, I'm not too sure if you can see it or not, but there is actually like a bump, a raised surface here, and that usually shows the direction of on or off. And on the back here, you also have the ability to put your connector in the back here rather than use the sides. And this is a piece of 14 gauge wire that you would get in a normal household circuits. And of course, you would just stab this right in here and make your two connections here, or you can use on the side. Now let's say you're going to try and wire this up and it doesn't have the identifier on it here. Well, you just get your two wires. Now there's continuity right there, and there's the bump. Now the switch is off. So that's a good way to identify if the switch is actually on or off. Then you get to another switch like this, and of course, this one here is completely smooth. So you have no idea what's going on there, right? Well, there's a reason for that. They don't have an identifier on here because this particular one, you will notice it's got two brass colored ones, screws, and the other one is black. So if you just put it on one, and you got continuity there. But if you come around to this side, no continuity. Now if I turn the switch, I'll have continuity here and none here. So you can tell what kind of a switch this is. And you know, many times you're looking at a switch and you're saying, okay, so where does the third one go? Like if you take a look at a receptacle here, you'll see that there's a ground here. Well, a lot of times what happens is this screw is missing. This is your ground. I don't know if you picked that up or not, but yeah, this is missing. So you do have to have a ground here. And a lot of times, even on a receptacle like this, the ground, this here, will always go to the casing. So let's take a look at one of these. And this is just your regular receptacle. And you've got these two connectors here. And then you see you got these are brass colored and these are silver colored. Now, of course, they correspond with the plug. So this is your hot wire and this is your neutral. And silver would identify with white, and the brass colored one would identify with your black wire. And of course, your ground or your bare one would go on like this. Now, a lot of people have, say, like a kitchen, and you'll see you can plug in two 15 amp circuits here. Well, they actually have two different sets of wires. And how they do that is on the side of your receptacle plug here, you'll see there's a little tab. If you look real close there, you can see that little tab. And all you do, if you want to have two separate circuits, is get your needle nose pliers and break that tab off so there is no more connection between the one and the other. So they'll actually have a 15 amp circuit on this side and a 15 amp circuit on this side. And that's how you can tell when you open up a electrical outlet box and you'll see all the wires in there. You know it's more than just powering up the whole thing. You got two separate circuits itself. Now on the back here, you have the same type of method that you can actually put your conductors in here, in these four spots, or you can use the screws applied. Now if you take a good look at this here, I'm going to show you in the future a little bit better, but if you take a look at right there, you can see there's like a little tab here. Well, you could press in on that tab and it will release the wire to come out. But I'll just show you here for reference. If you take a look at, say, this side here, it is attached. So there is conductivity between here and here, and this is in the wire just like this. And if we go to this one here, this tab that you press down is that wire in there, and of course on the other side as well. So let's take a look next at powering this up and loading the circuit up to 15 amps, because there's a lot of controversy, especially on YouTube. When I made a video a little while ago talking about the backstabbing method here, there's actually a specific word for this, but by putting the conductors in the back, a lot of people thought that was unsafe and shoddy work, and no electrician in his mind would wire something up like that. But you know what? They're all wrong. This is perfectly safe to do. You have the option of using the side terminals or using here. So let's take a look at that next. Okay, so we're going to take this receptacle right here. You can see I've used my screwdriver to put the ground on. And of course, you've got a choice of your two conductors. The black is always your power, and this is your neutral. And if you just go on the back of your plug here, silver matches to this one here. Just plug it in and take your black on this side and plug it in there, and that's, you know, that's pretty well it. Now if you want, you can use these ones here, back off the screw, put your conductor wire in there just like this, and tighten it down. So you do have the option of both of these like this. And like I said before, you can take a probe, you know, or a screwdriver like this, put it in here to pull the wire out. So now let's just take this regular receptacle and let's load it up with a circuit that can draw 15 amps and prove that this here is actually certified and meets all the requirements of the safety codes in the United States and Canada. So let's take a look next. Well, here we go. I got it all set up. She's real sketchy, guys. You don't want to be doing this yourself. This is strictly for experimental purposes. I got an angle grinder plugged in, and I've got a heat gun plugged in. And I know both of them together is over 15 amps, but they should be around 12, 13 by the time they're finished. I got all the conductors plugged into the back of the receptacle. I got my meter here. Let's turn them on and let's see what happens. We'll do the heat gun at full blast first. There we go. We put the grinder on. She's gonna get noisy. Okay, guys, I'm not going to leave this on for an hour to prove that you can use the connectors on the back of any of these particular electrical connections, and I think they are safe. Okay, so what do you think? This is it here, guys. Like, they don't fall out or stuff like that. You have to actually pierce them in the backside to get them out. And you know what? For the average do-it-yourselfer and homeowner, these are very easy to hook up. You don't have to twist them around here, none of that kind of stuff. And you know what? As far as I'm concerned, they are safe. This particular one here was made by Leviton, and it's got all the approvals that you need in Canada and United States. And of course, over in Europe, they don't use this. They're using a different type of electricity. They're using 240 volt, 50 cycles, I believe. And so for me, North America, this is a certified unit. And on the switches, they're all certified. I bought this at Home Depot. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put a link down below for a video that Leviton did showing exactly how to actually wire one of these up yourselves if you don't believe it. I mean, for people who are skeptics and say, you know what, this is not the right way to wire it up. Well, you know what? They don't have any credentials. If you want to take a look at a large corporation and see that this has been passed for years and years and years and years, and it has all the safety certifications, so what else are you going to do? Are you going to, you know, listen to people on YouTube, or are you going to listen to the regulators? And in Canada and the United States, this has passed all the regulations, it's passed all the safety testing. So what do you do, right? I mean, what I've shown you here today, I wouldn't repeat it myself. You know, like, I mean, if you're not too sure about doing stuff, this is strictly experimental use as far as I'm concerned. What I did today, showing you a little bit about my little bit that I know about electricity. I'm not a licensed electrician, and I don't have the background to say whether anything is good or bad, or whether it is safe or unsafe. Leave that with the regulators, and leave that with your particular country and your electrical safety boards that certify these type of connectors, and I think they're safe as far as I'm concerned. So thanks for joining me here today. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. Come back again, and I'm going to do some more electrical testing in the future, just a little bit, and we'll have some fun. Cheers.